Hi there and welcome back. Thank you for joining me again. So this series is called Move It On Monday, and it's using those things up. I had a basket, well, still got a basket, and it had got packaging in. All that stuff that you pick up around the house and all the rest of it, plus things what I'd started, or you know, you'll grab an envelope out to do something with and then you don't do something with it and you just shove it in this same place. So what I did is I separated things that wanted to go away, I put them away. All the packaging I put together, because I'm going to do another Trash Tuesday next month to get back on top of that. And I separated this kind of stuff. So I'm going to light the candle, which is still aged mahogany. The wick's getting quite low down now. Oh, rich mahogany. So I'm going to set that. Where's the best place? I'm going to keep it there because I don't think I'm going to be stretching over there. So I'm going to read out today's mindful quote, and it's, as long as you live, keep learning how to live. Yeah, I like that. Yeah. After I finish filming, I reread them again and, you know, have a few minutes actually thinking. And I'm really enjoying that because, you know, I've not been at work now since, well, really since my mum died, when we was nursing her in the middle of July. I did go back for a couple of weeks, but, you know, mainly I've been at home. And, you know, apart from crafting, watching a bit of telly, not a lot to actually get me thinking. I don't watch the news. I don't really keep up with anything because it's far too depressing. Not just now. I've not followed the news and stuff for 8-9 years. I just found that I worried about everything. And I mean, adverts, you know, when they're asking for money for charities and things, I'd just burst into tears. And I just think it's best that, you know, I don't know. And I don't mind living in oblivion, really. But, you know, people matter to me and things like that. So I'm really loving these quotes, because then I can sit and, you know, really ponder on it and think, not just what it means to me, but you know, on a more wider scale. So I'm really enjoying it. I hope you are too. I hope you're not always issues again with that blinking calendar, but at least we know the date. Right, so these are, I've pulled out, I don't know if there was more tags and things, there probably was. But I've got a selection of these music ones. Now, I do think these was a digital from Junie, who is Will Abound Journals. I think I won this, if I remember rightly. These ones I did on using your book pages challenge up. And these was just things that I was left with. So they're all backed and stuff. I've sat this morning and inked them. And it's got the beautiful text. It's, oh, I forget what it's called. Something Woman's Journal. Very similar kind of thing to Edith Holden. There's artwork in there, but it's only really small artwork. But it's a beautiful book. Can be really expensive. I managed to, it was still pretty expensive, but a quarter of what I've... Did I just whistle when I spoke? A quarter of what I have seen it as. And these ones are from a collage board. I'm guessing they're from a couple of collage boards because they're quite different. So that's what we're going to be doing. I'm going to do these ones first because obviously they're already collaged up and that. I'm just thinking probably a label and a picture and they'll be done, because I do want to get these finished in the session. If you saw last week's video, I did show you kind of what I was wanting to work through. And then I rethought it, you know, realistically, what am I going to get? You know, this 5 Mondays in the month, what am I really going to get finished off? So I did put some of this stuff back. So these three, I'm thinking, because they've got blues on and things, I'm going to kind of do them towards the projects that I'm going that I've started, the blue things. So I'm hoping that they will fit in. I'm thinking I'll probably put these away till till autumn or something, because they're very autumny. So I've just grabbed a load of like florals and birds. That's one of the pictures from that journal, what I was just saying. Which is the big, oh, I like that on there. So, I mean, I think that needs something else. But that one, I don't think it needs anything else. So, that's a really big one. I've poured some blue things out. That's maybe a little bit pasty. That's nice. Can you see that down there? I think you can. Okay, with that blue. Like both of those on there. Not so keen on that one on there. What does that look like? Yeah, I like that on there. So probably put something else there so it's not as, you know, pasty. I don't know if pasty is pale. We've been having a bit of a chat in the, we've got like a little Facebook messenger group with the moderators and admin from the group. And we were saying, you know, about when we've said different words and things, and people have thought that, you know, we've meant something different. How language is so different. And I think especially more like slang things. That bird's a bit big for everything. I like it on there. Could I cut his tail off? Is that one any bigger? No, it's smaller. Yeah, I do like that on there, so that's going to stay on there. Then I've got that lovely dragonfly. If you've been watching the put that on there, that needs something to break it up. I think those two are fine. Probably just a label that needs something, so does that. And I have not even got an image for this one. Let me see if I can pull out another bird. Did I finish what I was saying? Oh yeah, if you'd have been watching the planner, Kit, I've used some of these big things in that colourway doesn't go, does it? Oh yeah, he's lovely. So I will have to trim that round and ink it. Right, so let's we'll do these two first because these need the least on them. I've got some labels. Most of these labels are probably going to be from Nanine at Collage Type. Quite like that. I don't know if it needs to be a bit bigger. Oh yeah, that's nice. Yes, I'm gonna have that one on there. so it blends in way too much. If a black one, night. Well, I like that. Yeah, I like that. Okay, I'll pick one out for this one, even though it just needs some. Yeah, that's nice. And then I think probably just a bit of something down there. Oh, I like him on there. I wonder if I'll put something. I like that. It still needs something across it. So this one needs quite a big label, doesn't it? Colour-wise, it went okay. Oh, yes, I like that one. So I don't want any paper on that. I don't want any paper on that. Okay. I think that one's being more like so. What have I got? Oh, I like that once it's inked up. I think that just needs a strip down the side. Oh, and then I've got these ones, haven't I? Forgotten about those because they're a different colour. Right, so I've got some bluish things in here. So maybe I could do one of the frames. Oh, that's pretty. I don't think it goes. No, too pale. Yeah, I do really like that frame. But it needs something else. Maybe. Oh, I've got that edge in here. Totally different blue. It might go with that though. Oh, that's nice. Still feel like there's something missing. What's on that one? That one. Colour-wise, that's really pretty, but it doesn't go with the flower that I've chosen. About a couple of stamps. If I'm not too far down, I know that I am quite far down. Sorry, it's because I've got so much on here. So maybe if I move this across like so. Do I want those? No, I think it needs to come in over here. Like that. That needs to go in up there. Yeah, I'm fine with that. Does it want to be as high as that? Yeah, I still like that. Right, I just need something. No. Oh, what about a different coloured frame? No, no. No! Stop. You messed it up now. Right, look, we'll just have to pretend that that looks nice. Does it need something brown? No. Need something a bit paler. It's just liking that, but it still needs something else. No, too many numbers with that above, and I do like that. Oh, that's it. Make your choice. Yeah, I do like that. No. Oh, hold on. Some of these was from out there, your creative studio box. I like that. It's a bit pale, but I can ink it up. They're mushroom stickers. Yeah, I'm going to go for that. So, that's that one, which doesn't need any papers behind it. So, this one won't need any papers around it. I'm really liking that shocking blue. It really is shocking. I like it that way. I'm thinking maybe... Oh, I like that. Yeah, I'm liking that. No, I like all that straw paper with that bright blue. I like that, but then that makes me not want to use those. I don't know why. It's for me. It's just totally changed the colour tone. No. Didn't get much out, did I? Oh, I am really liking that. Maybe I could get away with that. Let's find something else. Some butterflies somewhere. No, it's too pale. No. Nope. Nope. I don't know what I'm looking for, but I've not found it. Oh no. Right, I think when that's inked up, I think it'll be fine. I think it just needs a bit more inking. So let's have a look. Wondering about this is some William Morris. I bought a little kit just with all these little journal cards. Oh, I wonder. Oh. I do like that actually. Yeah, I do. Okay. And I think it still needs some paper going across that middle. I think what I'm going to do, so I get these into one video. I'll do the sticking off camera because, you know, you don't need to see me stick. And then I can come back and show you. I really like that, but it really doesn't go. But... Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. I could do with a blue butterfly. I haven't got a blue butterfly, have I? Oh, no, that's a blue flower. Right, I'm going to have to go. Oh, I've got a butterfly here. What do we think? Oh, I like that. And I don't think that now needs any paper. So, that's that one. So, there's just these two, really. And the only one to bit, I've got all this different paper out at the side of me. So I don't want music paper. Now, do I want something to lighten it up? No. do I on this? Maybe. Let's have a... This is just piano roll music. I do have this in the Etsy shop. They're mixed packs of decorator's paper, piano paper, and some brown paper. Quite liking that. So, what else have I got? I don't think I want to grunge it. Maybe that down there. I don't want to get those flat boxes. I might be able to use those for something. Well, let's just start with this. No, it needs to be across because obviously everything's going. I could have the writing across. I'm not opposed to that. That label's not working now. Let's try that on there. Would have to be that way. You know what? That might be enough to break that up. Yeah, I like that. So that's that one. Right, let's get back to this one, which now I think this needs. I don't want to put any more on because it's already got four different, and then that's five. Oh, I don't know. In that, but then I need a, yeah, that's too pale. Let's have a look. I can just smell that candle now. That's not going to be too, nice. Nope, nope, nope. What did I say about the craft one before? No, that's what you said. You said no. Because if you'd have said yes, it would have been on there, wouldn't it? But it could have been a maybe, couldn't it? Oh. I wonder. I prefer that. And then I wonder, I don't know, like wondering. It's not working for me. It's just not the right tone. I don't think I just want to splash some. I don't want music. I'm just gonna leave it as it is. I wish I had a big, big label that would sit sit behind it, you know, like this kind of, not quite that big, but. Oh, hold on. Maybe a bit of. Now. This will not mind going. To check how long I've been videoing for, it seems, feels like a lifetime. I do like that. I still feel like there's something missing. But for now, I'm going to no, just leave it be. I'm gonna leave it at that for now. So I think what I'm going to do is pause or stop the video and I'll join them up and I'll get the rest of what needs ink and inked and glued down, and then we'll come back and do another set, because I'm on, oh, I'm only on 26 minutes. Oh, what shall I do? Right, that needs inking. That one can be stuck straight down. Let's do a couple and then I think I might have missed this when I was inking around the tags. It doesn't look very. I've got one of them big glueber things in here. I might have to get a pen. It's quite goopy. That's it. Super duper. Right, I'm using the, it's not Anita's tacky glue, is it? It's, oh, I forget. Yeah, so that's fine. I've just moved that. It's fine for that one. Oh, the pin's stuck to it. It's me saying, can you see? I bet you saw it before I saw it. Can you see? Yes. Going to just give this an ink round, because I do think I must have missed this one. Okay, is that still straight-ish? Yeah, so that's that one. Leave that to dry. Ooh. Just throwing it on the floor. How rude. Right, let's do. Yeah, I'm sure I inked these. Glue that bit down. I must have just skipped a few. Well, and obviously when you've done a collage with all your scraps and that, when you do cut them down, you do always get bits. Sticking up. You're best to run your hands over them to see what your hand catches. Okay, so I think around here. Yeah. Well, yes, I have got my arms pretty close to me. I've just had the booster jab, and I'm actually in quite a lot of pain. I've got like muscle pain. It's as if it's set me fibro off a little bit. I feel fine. It's just my whole body is aching. So I'm only going to do one video today. I've had a quick tidy around the house, and yeah, prep for this video. My goal was, well, I was going to do four videos because I really do want to get in front. And oh, come on, my fingers are a bit sticky. And yeah, sat here, and then it was like afternoon, and I thought, I don't feel very well. It takes me a bit sometimes to realise that I don't feel very well. I think because I'm used to all over body pain and aches and things. Yeah, obviously, well, to stop you from going absolutely mental, you do get used to a lot of the aches and pains because it becomes normal. That's, I like that one. Gonna pause. Okay, he just had a 10 minute barking fit, so I'm going to ink around this because clearly I've not inked around it. I was fibbing, must have, you know. Oh yeah, I've inked around it. No, I hadn't. So yeah, I don't know if I was still on about me being achy or what have you, but yeah, I feel very achy, but luckily I don't feel poorly. So hopefully I don't mind just feeling achy. But yeah, I was saying, because you know, I suffer body fatigue constantly, so my muscles always feel like tense and tired, as if, you know, you've done a run all the time. And I get cramps, and yeah, there's always something hurting. It's either my knees, my backs, my back, my hips, or all of them. So yeah, you just learn to drown it out. And you know, I've been lucky enough to be able to do that. It's very, I have to take medication. Not like there's I think there is some proper medication now for fibro, but it's rare that I take painkillers. Yeah, I've been very lucky that yeah, I've just been able to learn to block it out. So it can take me a while to realise that I'm in extra pain. And that's why, really, I do my sitting thing in the morning at the side of my bed, just so all my body can wake up. I do some stretches on my chair in between, you know, drinking cups of tea and watching YouTube videos. And yeah, just so I'm awake, I can actually feel how my body is feeling, kind of thing. But sometimes I just don't pick it up, and then, you know, after a couple of hours I'm like, oh my goodness, I'm in absolute agony, and I didn't really realize it. And that's what's happened today. But it's still at that point where I think if I concentrated on it, yeah. But yeah, so I'm trying not to overstretch. Really like that. That's so pretty. I'm not going to put any tabs on or anything because I'm going to wait to see if I want them to be top ones or side ones. That's the only. And I think with doing it on video as well, you feel like, oh, you know, the topper sometimes is the best thing. I think I love watching people do different toppers. But yeah, you never know what you're gonna do with it. And another one that I've not inked. So it kind of limits you then. So, but I'm sure you'll see me what I do with them, because I've got quite a few blue projects to do. Three different kits, and then I'm obviously doing the Tim Holtz as well. So it's quite a contrast, really. Tim Holtz, the grunge to the blue. And obviously it means I've had to have lots of kind of things out with working on different things. And I mean, all my table here, I'm lucky it's quite a deep table. When I say deep, it's probably, I don't know, 3 foot deep. So I can set a lot of things backwards, but backwards at the back. But I don't like things like piled up at the side of me unless I'm using it now, this minute. Otherwise, it confuses me. But I've recognised that, so I've got piles behind me. but they're all in nice piles. I'm thinking they're organised piles. I shall find out when I'm doing the videos and think that I've got everything out, and then you realise, oh damn, I forgot, something really important, which is normally the case. It's a good job we can pause. Which is especially with Colin barking, gosh. You never know when he's, it can be the slightest noise. I mean, sometimes, even if I drop something, it can make him bark and run downstairs looking out the window and running upstairs, checking all the rooms. And, I mean, like I say, I'm thankful that that he is, because I do feel really safe, with him. So, I mean, that's a nice thing. Put that right on the edge. Or am I? I'm going to do it like that. Okay. So, if I stick that down that line. And I have got a headache as well. But I think they're all, quite common side effects of the jab. I mean, the first jab, this is a sticker, I was really, really poorly. It took me about 2 weeks to get over it. The second one, I felt like I do now, just achy and headachy and stuff. And after a couple of days, it passed. And each day, there was less aching and stuff. So that's that one. That's not turned out as nice as I thought it would, which is funny, because like that one, I was thinking, oh, it's a bit boring, but I actually really like that one. I like this one. I think it's because it's quite light, but I've got to remember that the blues are quite light. I've been saving like these bright blues because I'm going to be doing a bright blue project at some point, but I won't go from doing the the blues to more blues. To be honest, I don't even know what I'm doing. Shock horror, because I mean, I am pretty organized, but I've made my mind up. I'm using all the Tim Holtz ephemera that I've made. Anything what's left over, I will put it in the shop after. Like I said, I've got these three blue kits printed off. Two of them from last year. Well, three. Yeah, I suppose all three of them from last year. But two of them from, quite middle of the year. And again, I've got a lot of blue things made, what I'd been making through the year in preparation for doing it. So, again, I'm a bit like, I'm not finishing until my stuff's finished. and then the rest I'll put in Etsy. But I suppose after that it will be botanicals, because you'll have seen my botanical tub, which I don't mind having lots of that, because you know that'll be my spring and summer projects. I've got a couple of paper pads that I want to use. I was bought for my birthday off two people, the Woodland Animals Care, which is Stamperia, and so I've got the 12x12 and the 8x8, and I've just sent off from scrapbooking.com the journal cards, a couple of extra 12x12 sheets, and some decorative pieces, you know, things like what you'd cut out on a die cut machine, that kind of thing. So I definitely want to do projects with them. I'm not sure what I want to do. I'm probably thinking a hardback, but I've never done a hardback, so that will probably be something new. And yeah, I'm thinking what else I've got to use. I mean, I've got two paper pads from that Hackney and Co. The Herbarium. I don't know why you say that. Herbarium. I think it's Herbarium. And another one of theirs, which is botanical. But I'm loathed, really, to make any more botanical pieces until I've used up what I've got. So I think really it's just going to be, let's use stuff up. I definitely want to get some Edith Holden in, because I do love doing the Edith Holden, which for me, you know, yeah, I do a lot of botanicals and things, but for me, I, you know, Edith Holden's quite girly, but I do really enjoy it. But that's that one. But I think I obviously do a toned down version. You know, a lot of other people, when they do Edith Holden, it's quite frothy, and you know, you can really I don't know, like, the words to use, but you know what I mean. Whereas I think I tend to either match it with like a green or a cream and keep it quite simple. I do have an Edith Holden playlist if you're pretty new to me, because I don't think I've done any for a while. It was probably last summer. I am pretty good. I do put everything in playlists. So yeah, you can go back and look. And I've also got Tim Holt's playlist. Yep. And this is pretty quick. I did well to say I was going to pause the camera. What are we on now? 43. Might have to call this a... Oh, did I go wrong? Oh. You know what? I'm going there. Now, that's really strange, because putting labels on like that isn't something that I do. Yet when I see other people do it, I think, oh, I love it. It makes it, like, stand out. It's, I don't know, I think your eye's just not expecting it. And I wouldn't have done that. So, and I really like it. So, yeah. Yeah, I love it. So that's that one. And this one, which I'm still like, I don't know, but I suppose everyone can't be a masterpiece, can it? I mean, I can, you know, when I put the tab on or whatever, I can always have some dangle coming down, or could say vellum over the top of it to give it that nice soft look. So just because you know, I don't like it now, this minute. I could add a bit of stamping onto that that straw paper, because it definitely does need something, but the things that I'd got out just for me didn't really go. So I'm going to pop that there. And then it's not straight. It's a bit skew with. I think the cutting on the label's skew with. So this is out of a bird box. A lot of the things that I've just used are from Nanine, of course, from Collage Type. There's a blue ephemera kit that I bought, which I can't remember who it's from, same as the William Morris, but it will be in the description of the blue things that I'm making. So yeah, I don't know, it definitely needs something down here, but at the minute I've just not got the right thing. So I'm going to call this a video, and I'm going to do the same as I did last week. I'm going to put another one up tonight, finishing off, and then, you know, if you don't want to watch it, obviously you know what I'm up to. Don't feel that you've got to watch it. So I've got these little music ones, what is it, 2, 4, 6, and I've got these ones, and I'm wanting to do these quite pale botanicals to go with the blue what I'm doing now. So yeah, I'm trying to just make, if I do make ephemera, you know, try and make it for what I actually need for now. Right, thank you very much for joining me. I hope I've been okay, because like I say, I am aware that I don't feel great, so I hope, you know, I've not come across as and I'll either see you tonight or I'll see you tomorrow. Thanks for joining me. Bye for now.